And now it's time to learn about an essential tool when managing your bank transactions. We will now learn about the register window. The register window is a window that allows you to see all of your bank transactions and how they were recorded. And in the very same window, you can add, remove, or change any of the bank transactions. And that's why it's such a handy tool. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Banking, Use Register. The Use Register window opens up for you to select which account to open in a register window. Cash and Bank is selected by default because it's the only bank type of account that we have. So let's leave it and click OK, and now we have the register window. When you look at the register window, you can scroll up and down and notice that every single bank transaction we had since the beginning of this course is recorded here in the register window. Notice there are two lines for every one transaction. This was our first direct deposit from Betty from a sale receipt back on February 1. Here's the top line and the second line of that one receipt. Let's jump down a little. Here's the first refund check that we gave to Alan Arby on March 9th. Here's the top line of that transaction, and here's the bottom line of that transaction. So the fields of every transaction are spread across two lines. This is because QuickBooks wants to give you a traditional view of what a register would look like in the days before the computer. You may notice that any deposit that we made is recorded here in the deposit column, and any check that we paid is recorded here in the payment column. And again, two lines for every one transaction. If you prefer to see all the transactions listed across one line, all you have to do is move the mouse to the bottom left of the register and click this box, one line. Now we have the exact same transactions. However, all the fields of one transaction are spread out across one line rather than two. So here's the refund check to Alan Arby. Here is the deposit from Candy, the direct deposit from Candy from Candy's sales receipt. Notice it has the same fields of information, except they are smaller so they can fit across one line. Now, for the purposes of this video, we will leave the traditional view and we will remove this check mark and work with the register having two lines for every one transaction. The register window is really a shortcut to two other windows that record transactions regarding your bank account. If you put the money in the payment field, QuickBooks will record this transaction exactly as if you opened the write a checks window and put in the same information in the very same fields. However, if you record the money amount in the deposit column, QuickBooks will record the transaction exactly as if you opened the deposits window and put the same information in the same fields. When we come to the register window, you can see this by double-clicking the type of transaction. If we scroll down to the bottom, or towards the bottom, let's take a look at the deposits that were made during the video regarding deposits. For example, March 27th, this is a deposit of $3,960. When we double click on the word deposit, the make deposits window opens up and we can see exactly what was recorded into this window. So we could have recorded the information either here in the register window or here in the deposits window, and notice the money amount is in the deposits column. When we take a look at this check, the check on March 30th, we can double-click the word check and we can see that this information was recorded in the write a checks window, but we could have taken the same information in the fields that we recorded here and put them in the fields of information in the check register window. It's the same information and it causes the same result. For more information on how to physically manage the transactions in the register window, I suggest that you view again video number 8 and video number 9 from the original website www.kindergartenquickbooks.org. When you come and watch the video in the YouTube window, you can click on the links in the description of this video to go directly to those two videos, which you should have seen at the beginning of this course. The register window is the only window that allows you to mark a transaction as having cleared the bank. Now, this will be explained better during the future videos regarding bank reconciliation, but let's take a look right now on how we would use the register to tell QuickBooks that we know a particular check or deposit has cleared the bank. In the very thin column between the payment money amount and the deposit money amount is a place where you can click a check mark to indicate if something has cleared the bank. For example, if we know that check number 203 is listed on the bank statement, we know it cleared the bank. If we click once to place the check mark here, we're going to get this warning that tells us that the normal way that we tell QuickBooks a transaction has cleared the bank would not be in the register window. It would be in the bank reconciliation window. But there are some times where you need to clear a transaction from the register window. If it asks, do you want to clear this transaction now? Just click yes to see that the check mark will stay there. This way, when we go back to the bank reconciliation window in a future video, you would see that this is already indicated as cleared. Let's click twice to remove it so that we don't damage anything before our first bank reconciliation. It is important to know that any account in your chart of accounts that is not an income or expense type of account can be opened in a register window. For example, we can record statement charges to a customer's account from the accounts receivable register window. From the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts, and click on Account Receivable. You find the account that you want to open in a register window, and then you can right-click and choose Use Register. Now our accounts receivable account has opened in a register window the same way that the bank account opened in a register window a few moments ago. Notice it not only says the change to accounts receivable, but it lists the specific customer as well. So let's use the register window to charge Betty $50 for her monthly maintenance charge. This is a statement charge that we will bill the customer for that we would not normally put on a separate invoice. Let's imagine the date that we charge Betty for this $50 is April 8. So, we go back to the account receivable register window, scroll all the way to the bottom, and record the information accordingly. Click on the date box and choose April 8. Now, leave the number blank and just choose the customer Betty. The item will be monthly maintenance, which is another charge that we have already put on the items list. Notice QuickBooks remembers that we put this on the items list in a previous video and remembered the amount of the charge was $50. When we click record, we know that both the accounts receivable in the chart of accounts as well as Betty's account and Betty's records have both increased by $50. When we take a look at the open invoice report, we can see that Betty was charged a statement charge on April 8th. Notice there is no due date because this April 8th charge is not a separate invoice. It's simply a charge that we added to her balance. You can see on this report that it increased her balance by $50, but it is not a separate invoice. If we double click on the transaction listed in the report, we go back to the register window, the very same window that we recorded the transaction in.